This is an absolutely wonderful day, and the Seattle weather has cooperated for us. A little bit of sun, a little bit of rain, everything. Will you join me in prayer? Father, I pray a blessing upon this day, upon this moment, for this couple. I pray that each and every one of us, Lord, would just be excited and blessed to see your hand upon them, and that you would just begin even now to strengthen them as we begin this marriage ceremony. And we thank you now in Jesus' name. Amen. Here's the question to you. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I share her with him. I give him.
He said yes. And get your bride.
Hard to let go.
Brought to the man, a woman. And Adam responded that, yep, this is the one I want. That's my paraphrase. But to make it simple, he recognized that this was the need that he had. Now God says in Ephesians chapter 4, or chapter 5, that there are descriptions on what he expects in a relationship. One of the things that's important about that is that there are a whole lot of verses talking to you, Jordan. And so God puts a lot of significance on how you lead your family, that are important. To be the strength, encourage, she doesn't have that at all. She has a lot of that, and you're going to learn that.
In my 34
years of being married, I have learned that my wife is
sometimes a lot stronger than me. And so I want you to remember
to love her and to remember when she says something, to listen. I'm going to read to you something out of Ephesians, particularly to you. As it says, husbands, love your wives just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word, that he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. To the wife, it says that she is to, that there's a word in the Bible that nobody likes. It says submit. Now, it doesn't mean what you're all thinking. What it means is that you, as a result of him loving and giving himself to you, that you would respect him and honor him as a result of that. Because this relationship is a mutual one. One isn't greater than the other. And the time that I've known Jordan, I know that he is a caring, loving, just a great, great guy. And I know my son picks his friends well. So I'm excited for what we're about to go into. Are you guys ready to do this? Well, before we do, where are you? There you go. You have your reading? Oh. Olivia is going to read the passage of Scripture.
I'm going to read 1 Corinthians 4 through 7. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It's not irritable, and it keeps record of being. It keeps no record of being wronged. Sorry. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, and is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance.
Guys, don't make her nervous. All right, are you ready to take your gospel first? This is the one day you don't have to think. All you have to do is repeat after me. I, Jordan Burnett.
I, Jordan Burnett.
Tepi Mineko Hasagawa. To be my wedded wife. To have and to hold. From this time forth. For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In health and in sickness. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. And to this I pledge you my love. Okay. I'm Mineko. Take thee, Jordan, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this time forth, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in health and in sickness,
to love and to cherish till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance. And to this I do pledge you my love. And will you be giving rings to one another? Okay, let's start. You have. This is Mineko. With this ring, I be wed. At this point, they are going to begin by indicating that the two lights that were in their individual lives will now be signified with the lighting of a unity candle, where these two individuals will now show a symbol that they are now one. Kiss your bride.
Jordan and Mineko Burnett.